treasure. Okay. I think you will agree if you have been reading previous bar examination questions. Paborito ito, for one reason or another. Okay? Hidden treasure. Remember, number one, first of all, what is considered as treasure? So, the law defines that in Article 438. It is any hidden and unknown deposit of money, jewelry, or other precious objects, the lawful ownership of which does not appear. In other words, hindi alam kung sino ang may-ari. Okay. If you see your neighbor one midnight digging a hole on a parcel of land near your house and hiding a jar full of jewelry, that is not hidden treasure. Okay? Alam mo kung sino ang nagbaon. Okay? The lawful ownership must not appear. Okay. The law enumerates money, jewelry, or other precious objects. It, applying the ejusdem generis rule, that should be limited to things of similar nature. Therefore, again, this does not include mineral deposits, okay, or oil. Hindi pwedeng hidden treasure yan. Okay? Pag-aari yan ng ating kabalikat sa kaunlaran, the state. All right. What is the rule with respect to hidden treasure? It belongs to the owner of the land, building, or other property in which it is found. If it is found by another person, in other words, somebody other than the owner of the property, and by chance, you have the one-half rule, 50-50. One half will belong to the owner, one half will belong to the finder. If, however, the finder happens to be a trespasser, he is not entitled to any rule, to any share. Okay. The law requires that the finding should be by chance. By chance. In other words, this would usually mean, and I think the traditional meaning ascribed to this phrase is that the finding was not intended. Totally unexpected. Not intended. In other words, the finder was not looking for the treasure. Supposing that a man has been given the usufruct of a parcel of land by his friend. And so he's staying there on that land. And then one day there was an old man who gave him what appeared to be an old map. And the old man told him that on a part of that property, there is treasure buried by pirates a long time ago. And so this usufructuary, believing what was told to him by that old man, digs at the precise spot indicated in that old map. And true enough, he finds hidden treasure. Will he be entitled to any share of the treasure? Will his finding be considered as a finding by chance? If you go by the traditional view as to the meaning of by chance, then it would seem that he would not fall under that category because he intentionally looked for the treasure. But I think this logic and good sense in the view advanced by others. According to them, when the law says by chance, that should be interpreted to mean by a stroke of good fortune. Let me put it this way. A lot of people have been engaged all over the Philippines in the search for the so-called Yamashita treasure. Even books have been written about the search for this treasure. A lot of people have engaged in diggings, have spent millions even to finance these excavations. But a lot of them have turned, well, we're not able to locate any treasure at all. In other words, even if you look for treasure, there is no guarantee, even if you are using an old map, there is no guarantee that you'll be able to find one. So, in that sense, if you do find treasure, your finding can be considered as by a stroke of good fortune. And in that sense, it can be considered as a finding by chance. Okay. If the finder was precisely employed by the owner of the land to look for treasure there, the finder, I submit, will not be entitled to any share under Article 438. His remuneration will depend on his contract or agreement with the landowner as to how the treasure will be shared or as to his compensation, direct compensation for the work which would be undertaken. Okay. Let's now go to accession. Another favorite area, of course. Favorite area. Accession. The general rule is contained in Article 440. If you are the owner of property, by right of accession, you are also entitled, you also own everything which is produced by that property or which is incorporated with that property or which is attached to that property, either naturally or artificially. Okay. The owner has the right by accession to everything produced, incorporated, or attached to that property. There are various kinds of accession. Okay? You have accession discreta, the right given to the owner to everything which is produced by the property. This is in turn subdivided into the three types of fruits which can possibly be produced: natural fruits, industrial fruits, and civil fruits. Natural fruits are the spontaneous products of the soil as well as the young and other products of animals. So, animal manure, that's natural fruit. Okay? Mushrooms, yung mushrooms which are not cultivated, which just sprout in the fields, especially after a thunderstorm the previous evening. Okay, those of you who come from the provinces, usually after a thunderstorm the previous night, if you walk early morning, you will be able to find mushrooms. But you have to be careful because some of these are poisonous. Okay, so that would be considered as spontaneous products of the soil. Okay. Industrial fruits, on the other hand, are those which are produced by lands through human labor and cultivation. Okay? If you're talking of mushrooms which are produced by a farm, they are cultured, etc., that would be industrial rather than natural fruits. Of course, you have the third type of fruit, civil fruits. Rents, the price of leases of lands and other property, life annuities, and other similar income. And then you have accession continua. You have, this is the right given to the owner to everything which is incorporated or attached to his property, either naturally or artificially. With regard to immovable property, you have accession industrial, subclassification of accession continua. You have first, with respect to immovables, accession industrial, which covers building, planting, sowing, and you have accession natural. What would fall under accession natural? Alluvion, okay, avulsion, change of riverbed, formation of islands. With regard to personal or movable property, you have adjunction or conjunction, commixtion or confusion, specification.